Hello to my students of grade 5. Welcome back to the channel. Today we'll continue the unit 3 of your class book. Let's start. The unit title is Growing Up. So number 1, we're going to read and answer. Read the two emails below and answer the questions. Before we read the emails, let's read the questions first. Number 1, who is the sender of the first email? 2, what animal does she want information about? 3, who is the sender of the second email? 4. What place in Oman does she write about? Now let's read. Dear Maha, I'm doing a project at school about turtles. My teacher told me that Oman is very famous for turtles. Please, can you tell me about where they live and how they grow? Thanks and best wishes, Nina. Now the second email. Dear Nina, thanks for your email. Yes. There are lots of turtles in Oman. There is a place called Ras Al Had where people go to see them. I found some pictures about how turtles are born, and I've written some information for you. I hope this helps you with your project. Bye, Maha. Great. Now, after we read, let's read the first question again and answer. Who is the sender of the first email? The sender is Nina. Number 2, what animal does she want information about? She wants information about turtles. Number 3, who is the sender of the second email? It's Maha. She was replying to Nina. Number 4, what place in Oman does she write about? She was talking about Ras Al Had. Great. Now let's move to question 2, read and write. Read the emails in activity 1 again. Write short answers to the questions. For example, here, is Nina doing a school project? Yes, she is. Great, let's answer number 2. Is her project about birds? No, it's not. Number 3, is Oman famous for turtles? Yes, it is. Number 4, does Nina live in Oman? No, she's not. 5, can Maha help Nina? Yes, she can. Well done. Next is read and listen. Remember, Maha told Nina that she'd written some information about turtles. Let's read together. 1. Turtles live in the sea. The female turtle comes out of the water to lay her eggs on the beach. 2. First, she digs a hole in the sand. 3. Then she lays her eggs. 4. Next, she uses her back feet to cover the eggs with sand. 5. Then, she goes back to the sea. 6. After 8 weeks, tiny turtles hatch out of the eggs. Finally, the baby turtles run into the sea where they live and grow. Moving on to grammar, let's listen and think. These are pictures of babies. Let's see what babies can do and what they can't do. 1. Sleep. Can they sleep? Yes. 2. Can baby ride a bike? No, they can't. 3. Can they drink milk? Of course they can. 4. Can a baby read a book? No, they can't. 5. Can a baby use a phone? No. 6. Can a baby cry? Yes. 7. Can a baby use a computer? No, of course not. 8. Can a baby play with toys? Yes. Now number 2 is ask and answer, like we discussed before, but discuss with your friend. For example, can a baby cry? Yes, a baby can cry. Can a baby ride a bike? No, a baby can't ride a bike. And so on. Next is read, think, and match. Let's see together these pictures. The picture in A, it's a kangaroo. Picture in B is penguins. Picture C is crocodile. And picture D is parrots. So 1. What are these animals? They can fly, but they can't swim. Correct, it's D. 2. They can swim, but they can't fly. The answer is B. Number 3. It can jump, but it can't fly. The answer is A, correct. And the last one, 4, it can swim, but it can't climb. Yes, C. Great. Now, number four, listen, read, and think. It has wings, but it can't fly. It lives on the ice, not in the sky. What is it? Can you tell me? Correct, they are penguins. Number two, you can see it, but you can't touch it. It adds color to the sky, but it can't fly. What is it? Correct, it's the rainbow. Last one, three, it can move, but it can't walk. It can fly, but it can't talk. It carries people, but they can't carry it. It's not a bird. So what is it? Yes, it's a plane. Well done. Moving on to listening and speaking. Look, listen, and match. Look at the pictures. Listen to Omar and Leila talking. Match each sentence to the correct picture. Okay, ready? Listen carefully. I can play football.
I can use a calculator.
I can ride a bike. I can play the drums.
I can use a phone.
I can play volleyball. I can ride a horse. I can play the piano. I can ride a camel.
I can play table tennis.
I can use a computer. I can play the guitar. Great. Now number two, ask and answer according to the last activity, but this time you're answering by yourself if you can or cannot. For example, can you play the piano? Yes, I can. Can you ride a horse? No, I can't. Number three, listen, complete, and talk. This time we're going to listen to Pam and Brian talking. Put a tick on the chart for the things they can do and a cross for the things they can't do. Ready?
Brian, can I ask you some questions?
For a survey, of course.
Yes, okay.
Can you play basketball?
Yes, I can.
Can you?
Me? No, I can't. But I can ride a bike.
Can you?
Yes, I can.
Okay, can you play the piano?
No, I can't. Can you?
Yes, I can. I love playing the piano, and I love using the computer. Can you use a computer?
Yes, I can.
Okay, last question. Can you speak Arabic?
Arabic? No, I can't. Can you?
Yes, I can. I'm learning it with my friend Maha.
Wow, how do you say hello in Arabic?
Ahlan.
Next is the butterfly game. I'm sure you love games. So you have start point and finish point. You can color these numbers with any color you desire. Are you ready? Next is writing. Look, read, and match. This is the life cycle of a seed. We have 7 pictures and text here. You have to look at the pictures, then read the text, match each text with a picture. Let's solve this one together. The first one is already done for you. The seed is in the ground. What about number two? What can you see what's happening? Yes. First, the seed grows a white root. The root grows down into the ground for food and water. What about number three? Yes, then the seed grows a shoot. The shoot gets bigger and grows up to the sunlight. What's happening in number four? Yes. Next, leaves grow from the shoot. And five, then the seed grows into a plant. Number six, the plant grows flowers. And finally, the flowers grow seeds which fall on the ground. That was interesting, the life cycle of a seed. Don't forget this. Moving on to spelling and punctuation. This is very important, so focus with me. We use commas when we want to take a little rest in a sentence. First, the seed grows a white root. See, we used comma here. And we have, finally, the flowers grow seeds. See, it's a rest. Finally, then we complete our sentence, but we have to put comma. And also, we use commas to separate things in a list. For example, the plant grows roots, comma, shoots, comma,
leaves and flowers. Understood? We use commas also to separate things. We do not usually put a comma before the word and. So whenever we have two things, which is the last thing, we don't use comma, we use the word and. Understood? Great, let's move on to number two. Write. Rewrite these sentences into your exercise book. Put capital letters, full stops, and commas into the correct places. Let's solve one together. Leila enjoys swimming, tennis, and going shopping. So where should we put comma? Exactly, we put it here. Number two, my family is planning to visit Salalah, Nizwa, and Muscat. Where should we put the comma? Exactly, here. Three, Ali eats bread, cheese, honey, and eggs for breakfast. Can you tell me where should we put the commas? Exactly, bread, cheese, then honey and eggs. Four, we go to school on Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Exactly, we put them here. So the rules are very important. Don't forget where to put the exact commas on their places. Let's move on to three. Read, think, and write. Read the words in list A and B below. Write the plurals of words in list A. Write the singulars of words in list B. Be careful. You need to use lots of different spelling rules. Okay, let's see the examples given. In list A, we have diary becomes diaries. In list B, strawberries becomes strawberry. Because in A, we write the plurals, and B, we write the singulars. Let's start in the box A. Two, we have box, it becomes boxes. Three, we have fly, it becomes flies. Four, we have bus, it becomes buses. Five, we have watch, becomes watches. And the last one, six, butterfly becomes butterflies. Amazing. Let's move on to B. Brushes becomes brush. Three, dresses, for one, we say dress. Four, babies, for one, we say baby. Five, foxes becomes fox. Six, lollies, for one, we say lolly. Amazing. Next is do a project. Salima and Neda are doing a project about the Arabian oryx. They have made an information page. Look at the picture and read the information. Let's read this one together. So, one, the Arabian oryx. It's made by Salima and Neda. So here is the horn of the oryx, the eye of the oryx, his head, his hoof, his tail, his leg. So in number four, where it lives, the oryx live in the desert in central Oman. Oryx live together in groups or herds. They never live alone. What it looks like? Adults are white, but baby oryx are born brown. Both male and female oryx have two long straight horns between 50 and 75 centimeter long. What it eats? Leaves, grass, roots, and shoots. What other interesting facts? Oryx can smell rain from very far away. After it rains, they travel across the desert to look for fresh grass. Now, after we read, let's find and match. Look at the different parts of Salima and Nada's information page in the previous activity. Find the numbers on the page which matches each of the sections below. So what is the number that talks about labels for body parts? Correct, it's number three. The number that talks about the information boxes is number four. The title of the project, yes, is number one. And the names of authors is number two. Well done. Now next is look and match. Match the names of each animal in the box below with the correct picture. So we have here some example of the animals in Oman. Let's solve this one together. Number one, scorpion. Can you tell me which picture is scorpion? Yes, picture F. Number two, goat is picture C. Number three, dolphin is picture E. Number 4, fox, is picture G. What about 5, Arabian camel? Yes, picture A. And 6, eagle. Can you see an eagle? Yes, picture B. What about 7, hedgehog? Yes, it's picture H. And the last one, Arabian leopard, is picture D. Woo! Now let's read the interesting story of Muscat Tom together. Not many people today know the story of Muscat Tom. He lived in Oman almost 200 years ago, and he was very famous. However, Muscat Tom was not a person, he was a whale. Sailors on ships visiting Muscat gave him his name. There are many different kinds of whales. Muscat Tom was a fineback whale. Fineback whales are the second largest living creatures in the world, after blue whales. Fineback whales are very big, but they can swim very fast, up to 37 kilometers per hour. They weigh up to 70,000 kgs and can live until they are 90 years old. The female is bigger than the male and can grow a length of 27 meters. Muscat Tom lived in and around Matra Harbor. At that time, there were a lot of sharks in the water. They ate all the fish and the people were afraid to go into the sea. But Muscat Tom chased the sharks and killed them. So the fishermen and sailors and the people of Muscat loved him. One day, Muscat Tom went away. The people were very sad because the sharks came back and started eating the fish again. But after a few days, Muscat Tom returned. This time, he was not alone. He brought a female whale with him. The female whale stayed with Muscat Tom and helped him chase the sharks. Muscat Tom lived in the sea around Muscat for nearly 40 years. Isn't that interesting? Great, now after we read, let's solve this one together. Read and think. Read the text on page 36. Circle the correct option in each sentence. Number 1. Muscat Tom was a sailor or whale. Correct. Whale. 2. The largest living creature is the blue or fineback whale. It's the blue whale. 3. Fineback whales swim very slowly or fast. Correct. Fast. 4. People were afraid to go into the water because of the whales or sharks. Correct. Sharks. 5. Muscat Tom came back with a female or a male whale. Yes, female. And the last one, 6. Muscat Tom lived in the sea around Muscat for more than 40 years or almost 40 years. Correct. Almost. Amazing. Now number 2, read and complete. Read the text again. Complete the table with information about the fineback whale. I will give you time to solve this activity alone. All you have to do is search for the age, weight, length of female, swimming speed. Are you ready?